the World Wrestling Federation. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
The Intercontinental title on the line. The Macho Man Randy Savage, accompanied by Elizabeth, facing the challenge of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Yeah, what an athlete you are, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Fantastic athlete. You're very, very quick. Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt definitely up this particular night in the Boston Gardens, where way back, February the 8th, 1986, I took that belt. Yes, I did. I won the big one. And that's what Ricky the Dragon Steel has failed to do in his career. Win the big one.
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
What did I say?
George the Animal Steel, perhaps he's still on your mind?
Listen, man, last time in the Boston Gardens, we fought all over the building. And I'm glad I got any brains left after that match, but guess who won? Guess whose hand went up in victory? The Macho Man Randy Savage won the big one. And I remember Ricky Steamboat. Do you remember Don Morocco? Yeah, when the big one came along, you couldn't handle it. Jake the Snake Roberts, same thing. Now you're a three-time loser. You come to the Boston Gardens. You can take a look at this, but you can never get it.
That when Jake Roberts was out here, he talked about wanting to wear the Intercontinental title belt around his waist, and a lot of wrestling fans and promoters alike feel that you are long overdue for a title shot yourself.
Well, I would certainly like to wear that belt around my waist. There's only one person in the way, and that's Mr. Savage himself. As I recall, he is just right behind the champion when it comes to stats. You know, when it comes to who's up there in the very, very top, the top five, the top ten, and so on. Now, Savage has had that belt for a number of months now, but the only thing I can say about that man is that possibly he could be a smart businessman, Kenny, because he only has to defend that championship once every 30 days, which has given him some longevity out of it.
Let me ask you this, Ricky. A lot of people feel just the presence of Elizabeth at ringside is enough of a distraction to Savage opponent.
Elizabeth!
Oh, look who...
Elizabeth!
Mention Elizabeth and you see who comes.
Savage! Use Elizabeth!
Wrong.
But George tells Steamboat, George, worry about Elizabeth. Steamboat, beat Savage, beat champion.
So the Intercontinental title on the line. The Macho Man Randy Savage against Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the Boston Garden, a very familiar building to you, Macho Man.
I made the Boston Gardens famous on February the 8th, 1986. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, you had all the opportunities in the world to make a fool of yourself on the Halloween. Yeah, but it's not Halloween on November the 1st. It's Macho Madness, yeah, in Boston, in the Boston Gardens. As I walk down that aisle in the Boston Gardens, the history of the Celtics, yeah, ring in my ear, but out the other side with no effect. Not at all, no. Because you're talking Macho Madness, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, and I'm talking controlling your own atmosphere, which is something that I am able to do at any particular time. Time distortion, Mr. TV announcer, is a, yeah, it's a talent. It's a talent, yeah, but once you're in it, you gotta know how to get out. I'm the best talented wrestler that ever was, past, present, and future. And you, man, are gonna find that out on November the 1st, Boston Garden. Macho Madness!
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from the Isle of Samoa, weighing 242 pounds, C.B. Uffy. His opponent, soon to be led towards the ring by Elizabeth from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 239 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
Where's Elizabeth? Whoa! Doesn't she look lovely?
You know what I like is the ovation that the Macho Man gets when he heads to the ring.
No, the ovation.
sensational matchup.
Should be a great, great matchup. CVAFI from the South Sea Islands, real good aerial attack. Randy Macho Man Savage, you don't have to explain him. Intercontinental champion, possibly the possessor of the most devastating move in wrestling, that big elbow off the top rope.
Well, a lot of individuals have been gunning for the Macho Man, I can tell you that, and I think it's taking its toll also on Randy Savage. Almost everyone would like to have a piece of the Macho Man, Randy Savage. As a matter of fact, Billy Jack had a match with him, I'm sure you remember, about 3 weeks ago. Here's what Billy Jack had to say about the match.
Randy, Macho Man Savage, this is right at you, brother. You're tough, you're Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, you got Miss Elizabeth, but all besides the point, I had you beat in a full Nelson. Down the road, brother, you and me are gonna go toe-to-toe, Daddy.
Yes, indeed. And I, for one, would like to see that rematch. And he certainly had the Macho Man defeated, I think. Drop toe hold, nicely done. CVAFI on top of the Macho Man.
Well, I know, personally, McMahon, the reason you're dying to have Macho Man put out of wrestling is I think that you want a chance at Elizabeth. I think deep down in your heart.
I'd like to have a what?
A chance at maybe taking Elizabeth out on a date or something. And the only way is for one of these guys to take the Macho Man out of it.
Whoa, look at that. He's going to be taken out right about now, too. Whoa, almost three. CVAFI with a drop kick. Only two.
Well, I'll tell you, you might be right. Macho Man has started off extremely slow, and maybe it is taking its toll on.
I don't think he's starting off slow. It's just that CVAFI give credit to CVAFI give credit where. Oh, well, look at that. Wait a minute. That's it. Pick on Elizabeth. CVAFI from behind. Oh, God. The Macho Man preoccupied with Elizabeth. Better keep his eyes on this man, CVAFI. Over. CVAFI scoops up the Macho Man. Slams him to the canvas. It's going up to the rope now. Whoa!
Oh,
oh, my.
You know what his mistake was there, McMahon? He looked out to the crowd for a little bit of approval, and it delayed the move and caused Macho Man the chance to raise those legs up.
He's like, yes, he's coming down. Right across the back of CVAFI. Macho Man with CVAFI. It's been a tremendous matchup. He dropped him face first right on the retaining barrier. Macho Man.
But if you'll notice, he helped him into the ring.
Yeah, helped him in, all right. Look of concern on Elizabeth's face a moment ago, and why not? Macho Man. Macho Man Randy Savage victorious.
Here is your winner, the Intercontinental Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
Up and right in the midsection. I'll tell you, they took an awful lot out of CVAFI. That really hurt him badly. And of course, from that, here comes the Macho Man from the top rope with that devastating elbow of his. But as you can see, CVAFI was already badly hurt.
Stand by, everybody. A special update with World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan with some nutritional tips.
The following is a title match scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring from Portland, Oregon, weighing 246 pounds, Billy Jack Haynes. And soon to be making his way to the ring, accompanied by his manager, Elizabeth, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 236 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
controversy in the last match, but the controversy is gonna disappear after this title match with Blue Jack. Number one wrestler professional wrestling, Macho Man Randy Savage. No more controversy.
Well, there certainly was a lot of controversy, Bobby. In fact, Billy Jack got ripped off.
Billy Jack didn't get ripped off. He deliberately got himself disqualified because he didn't want to look embarrassed.
Take a look at the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion and his manager, the beautiful Elizabeth, and look who's the referee for this one.
I can't see right now.
Danny Davis.
So?
Well, let's hope he's on his best behavior.
Get off his case, Monson. That's all I had to worry about Danny Davis. I had a pretty easy life.
I'm telling you, when you're, this is a title match, one of the few times in the history of the World Wrestling Federation that any kind of a title was on the line.
On a television match, you're exactly, the Bulldogs won't do it, Hulk Hogan won't do it, because they're all yellow. But there's a man with integrity.
How about the King? Would he put the crown on the line?
King would put the crown on the line every hour of the day.
Macho Man with an arm wringer right off the bat on Billy Jack, who reverses it immediately and goes into a side headlock. Oh, look at the power in that side headlock. Macho down on his knees on the canvas. Awesome power possessed in that upper body of Billy Jack Haynes, and everyone knows what he can do if he slaps that full Nelson on you. Shoulder block sends the champion down.
Well, he's a powerful man, all right.
But he's
Well, I admit the truth. He's a powerful man, but he's not real bright.
Beautiful shot right over the shoulder of lovely Elizabeth, who has to be concerned about this title definitely on the line tomorrow. Look at the champion with a handful of hair, Bobby. You see that?
Yeah, I see that.
Okay. Is that illegal?
Yep, that's illegal.
Okay.
I don't care.
Well, obviously. Referees didn't seem to care either. Knee right into the kidney area of Billy Jack, and a very concerned look on the face of Elizabeth. I don't blame her. Macho Man in control right now as he rams him into those turnbuckles.
What does it say on the back of Billy Jerk's trunks?
Portland, Oregon, does it say that?
I think it doesn't. At least he'll know where to send him when we're done with him.
Oh, please. Two count only by the champ. Oh, he couldn't hold him up. Danny Davis over there, one count only, and the champion kicks out. Delivers a double axe handle right to the back of the head of the challenger. Snap Mare takes him over. Oh, set him up beautifully for that one. Let's give credit where credit is due. This guy has not been a closet champion by a long shot. He's taken on all comers.
He certainly has.
Oh, look at this. Some 15 feet high. Macho Man about to come down. Oh, he nailed him.
I think we've seen the last of Billy Jerk Haynes.
Billy Jerk Haynes can certainly take a lot of punishment, as we've seen before. Savage having some choice words with some of our ringsiders in this capacity crowd here. The wrestling challenges, we hooks the leg. He's not going to get it that way. This guy can take an awful lot of punishment and come back. Suplex, no, nice block by Billy Jack. And he gets one of his own. But that also took a lot out of him, Bobby.
No, it sure did. He shouldn't have even tried that move. I'd have been Billy Jack. His best bet would have been to give up during instructions.
You might give up during instructions.
No, if I was Billy Jack.
Oh, you were Billy Jack. Well, thank God you're not.
Yes, exactly. I love being Bobby the Brain.
I'm sure you do. Oh, nice reversal by Billy Jack. Look out, backbreaker, yes. Well executed, even though he's in a great deal of pain.
See, if he'd have covered him right now, I believe he'd have had him.
He couldn't cover him, Bobby. He's hurt too bad. He's taken a tremendous amount of punishment.
He's not that bright. He's not that bright.
His back's hurting, Monsoon.
It sure is. He blocked that move again. Oh, look at that slam! Showing us the power. Billy Jack, and look at Elizabeth. She doesn't like to see that kind of power either. Her man's in trouble. Deep trouble. Title in trouble, perhaps.
But he's a champion. You watch him.
Went for a clothesline, didn't get it. There's the pull Nelson. Slapped down right in the middle of the ring. We're going to have a new champion. Danny Davis, what is he doing? Why doesn't he ask him?
He's going to It looked to me like Randy Savage swung, and Billy Jack, he was whipping him around, he hit Danny Davis.
Let's see if we can find out for sure.
Here is your winner. Wait a minute. Due to the fact that Billy Jack Haynes swung his opponent into the official, I disqualify Billy Jack. Decision. The winner of this bout as a result of a disqualification and still Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion Randy Macho Man Savage.
Look at that. You're looking at a beaten man right there, Bobby.
I think it was a very fair and just call.
It was stinking. It was disgusting. No way, shape, or form. Danny Davis is not a decent referee.
Oh, you're wrong. Why don't you take another look at it?
I'd love
Billy Jack deliberately swung him into the referee because he knew he couldn't get him with his own hold. He was going to lose face, and Billy Jerk just couldn't get the job done, Billy Jerk.
They're literally escorting the champion out of here. He saved his belt. Here it comes right here. That Phil Nelson applied right in the center of the ring. And look at this. Macho Man did that on his own.
No, he did not.
He saved his own skin.
He did not.
The following bout is scheduled for one fall. It is a non-title contest. Introducing first the manager, Elizabeth. From Sarasota, Florida, weighing 236 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage. Soon to be entering the ring area from Union City, Tennessee, weighing 225 pounds, the Birdman, Coco Beware.
Holy mackerel, you can feel the excitement in the air as this capacity crowd goes bananas as Coco Beware and Frankie make their way down to the ring here this week on Wrestling Challenge for a non-title matchup with Randy Savage.
It's a shame, Guerrero, when your only friend in life happens to be a pigeon.
Well, you can bet that he's got plenty more friends. It's not a pigeon, incidentally. It's a parrot.
It's probably a pigeon with tempera paints on it, watercolors.
Take a look at him, one of the most exciting individuals today here in the World Wrestling Federation. One of our beautiful federettes with a big smile on her face.
That bird talk.
I suppose it does. Why don't you go over and try to have a conversation with him?
Wouldn't talk to anybody to have anything to do.
Oh, look at that. Macho Man does a number on the Birdman as he tries to enter the ring. Pulling out all the stops, even though this is a non-title matchup. Randy Savage not wanting to take any chances with this. You know, look at, he's still got his ring rolled on. Double axe handle to the back of the neck, and Coco's in a lot of trouble. When's he going to take his ring attire off, Bobby?
How would I know that? I'm not in the ring. You think I know everything? I realize I'm a brain, but there's some things I just can't help you with, Monsoon.
Unbelievable. Had an opportunity early on to speak to the Macho Man and ask him if all these title defenses were wearing him down and taking a toll on that body.
Vulnerable? Vulnerability? Champion's gonna go on and on and on for thousands of years.
What a dreamer. Thousands of years. Who does he think he is? Methuselah?
Well, I'll tell you, if you see enough of him, you'll feel like you've been watching him 1,000 times. It's such a treat.
Reigning Intercontinental Champion Randy Savage, 2 count only, as the Birdman sneaks out the back door. Finally got all his ring attire off. Oh, look at Frankie coming alive. The Birdman going bananas as Coco is doing it all here on Wrestling Challenge this week. Wow, big roundhouse right. Sends a champion down.
Can't believe it, the people like this bird.
What do you mean they like?
Of course they like him. He's exciting. Drop kick right out of nowhere. Champion flat on his back in the center of the ring. Look out. Coco on the top turnbuckle. A little bird action. Bombs away, coming up. Oh, what a drop kick.
Over for the cover. No, he's got his foot in the ropes.
The mark of a champion.
Saved by putting his foot in the ropes. That's the mark of a champion.
Those are the rules, Monsoon. He's taking advantage of them.
Well, maybe one of your champions.
You certainly never went to the ropes?
Certainly not one of mine. Look out! An attempt at a high cross body. And Savage nowhere to be found.
That bird may take off pretty good, but it lands pretty hard, don't it?
He took off right over that top rope. Never touched a thing. Hard down under the floor. Look out. Savage now perched some 15 to 18 feet above him. Oh, he got caught on the way down. Right in the lower abdomen. Everybody's in this shot, including Frankie.
Frankie don't even care.
Oh, look at that. He just rammed Savage's neck right into that steel railing. And now into the steel post.
Should be disqualified right there for that.
Both men could well, in fact, be counted out here as they both spent an awful lot of time outside that ring.
Coco wouldn't let Savage get back in.
Please. We're going to have to wait for the decision here as Savage, not too happy with the outcome of this match. Let's get the official word.
The official decision on this bout, a double count out.
Ah. Just as I expected, both men outside the ring for an awful long time. Double count out, but still tremendous showing here by Coco Beware.
I have good news and bad news. The bad news is there wasn't a winner. The good news is we still have Savage as our Intercontinental Champion.
Well, even if he had lost right in the center of the ring, he still would have been champion. It was a non-title match.
That's what I told you, Monsoon.
And Coco still wants a piece of the champion. Let's go back and take a look at the high flyer here. Watch this beautiful drop kick by Coco. Oh, whammo, what a shot. If he hadn't been closer to the ropes, that would have been over, Bobby.
Well, he's a mark of a champion. He knows where he is all the time.
One of the few times we see the high-risk move missed by the Intercontinental Champion, Randy Savage. Now look at this. Rammed throat first right into the steel barricade.
Well, I have to say this. Randy Macho Man Savage has never missed coming off that top rope.
Right now, wrestling fans, it's time for Wrestling Rebuttal Time.
Now, wrestling fans, a bit earlier in the program, you heard from JYD, the Junkyard Dog, with a, if you will, hit list. And I think it's safe to say heading up that hit list was none other than the Intercontinental Champion, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, who is certainly entitled to his thoughts. But before we get into that, I must congratulate you. The Randy Savage doll, not only number one, it is a very good likeness indeed, but I understand selling very, very well.
You know something? Just a little while ago, right over there, the Macho Man Randy Savage doll dropped the big elbow on the Junkyard Dog and pinned him 1, 2, 3. Oh, yeah. And that is not far from the truth. In fact, it's just about exactly what's going to happen or what will happen or experience Macho Madness, Junkyard Dog, because it's here to stay, yeah. And you're just passing through my world, yeah. You just take a hike down the road, and I don't pick up hitchhikers, yeah.
Now, Macho Man, if I may, there seems to be yet another individual who is talking about challenging for the Intercontinental title and creating quite a stir, if I may add, in the form of Jake the Snake Roberts.
Yeah, now he's the one that's supposed to be so cold.
Coldest-blooded wrestler, many people think, in the annals of the sport.
Oh, is that right? Well, Mr. Jake the Snake Roberts, you have never gotten any notoriety until you mention the Macho Man Randy Savage's name. The Snake Pit is nothing to be proud of. The Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt is everything. Yes, it is. It's everything, Snake Roberts. So you're not nobody until you beat somebody. And the number one wrestler in professional wrestling is the Macho Man Randy Savage. And you can experience Macho Madness. Oh, yeah, you can. Yeah.
Rough around the edges tonight.
Oh, come on. You know how looks can be deceiving. I mean, things that look very good wind up leaving a bad taste in your mouth. I mean, people have always said about me, how can anything that looks so hot be so cold? Well, it's easy. You see, time has done that to me. Your time, that's right. But you know, I'm causing problems in the World Wrestling Federation because I'm different. Because I'm an innovator, not an imitator. Because I walk a different line, because I don't need nobody, you see. I don't need no managers. I don't need no friends. And now everybody's going, well, can you believe he's even challenging the Macho Man? What do you think I'm in this sport for? Fun? No, it's money, my man. And money runs the thing, you see. Money runs the world, whether you like it or not. If you got money, you can get anything else you want. And if I have that Intercontinental Championship, my man, money's gonna be a lot more plentiful around my house.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next match is scheduled for 1 hour with one fall, with a 60-minute time limit. It is for the Intercontinental Championship title.
Still breathing, that can't say Elizabeth's presence at ringside, and that dress would not be a distraction.
Take a look at the reigning Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. He is, in fact, number one as far as that title is concerned.
He did, as you mentioned, gain it in a rather questionable manner, but you can't take anything away from him since that night in Boston.
Elizabeth and physically pulled her right in front of him. Now he's complaining about the chain. He wants a chain out of the ring. Elizabeth's scared. Look at her. Chant going out by this crowd here in the Summit. JYD. Referee's going to make him get rid of that chain, in fact. There it goes. Now he's threatening with the belt. Well, we're going to make him get rid of that too, because the belt is definitely on the line here.
And once again, we see the Macho Man seeking sanction behind Elizabeth. Why would she stay with him?
I don't know. Oh, look at that. The dog ends up with the belt. The easy way, the hard way, is to win it. He just snatched it away from the referee.
I don't quite think that's what Randy Savage had in mind.
Has to be brought over here to the timekeeper's table, because this is definitely a title match.
Junkyard Dog telling referee Dave Hebner, all I want to do is look at it.
Uh-oh. The dog, look at that, turned his back. You can't turn your back on the Macho Man. Well, we ended up with it here eventually at the timer's table. What it's all about, the gold, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt.
All the prestige and money that goes along with it.
The bell's rung and we're underway here. And he's still got his shades on. Why's he got to back it up? The bell rang, the match is underway. Macho giving away a lot of power here, as is obvious with that particular move right there. But the speed and agility and cunningness has to go to the champion.
No question. Classic matchup, speed and quickness against size and strength.
That's what it's all about. History could be made here tonight in the Summit.
A lot of people feel that JYD, if he can keep his mind on the Macho Man and not stray over to glance at Elizabeth, could be the man to end the reign of Randy Savage's Intercontinental Champion.
And nobody knows that any better than the Macho Man. or not so Macho Man, as I like to refer to him. Hebner warning JYD about something. Nice go behind, quickly underneath. Gonna lose this power hold right here. He can't match the power. Oh, headbutt right between the eyes. Sends the champion down to the canvas. Well, JYD's got to get back now. He's in the corner, in the ropes. Referee doing a good job right now, keeping him back. Very concerned look on the face of Elizabeth, and rightly so.
So far tonight, Gorilla Randy Savage has not been all that anxious to tie up with the JYD.
Nope.
As you say, he may be a bit leery of whether or not he'll be able to walk out of the Summit later this evening with the gold around his waist.
Another big headbutt, and out goes the champion. Out to, maybe we could get Elizabeth. Maybe we could, Elizabeth, could you come here a moment, please? Let me ask you, dear. Things are not going too well for the champion right now. You're sort of, your game plan has sort of gone down the tube, so to speak.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
I can't. I'm sorry. What, Mr. Monsoon? I'm sorry. I'm saying that
things are not going too well for you right at this particular point.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
What are you talking?
Gorilla Randy Savage almost became possessed, but all you were trying to do was talk to Elizabeth, something you've done many times to many of the managers here in the World Wrestling Federation.
What is your problem? He has a definite problem. He became paranoid.
He really did.
Just asking her a simple question, that his game plan looked like it wasn't going too well.
You see that hot dog?
What is it?
You and me, baby. You got me.
So talk about the turnabout is fair play. One distraction deserves another, I guess.
Well, the dog took advantage of that situation. That'll teach the Macho Man to pay attention to what's going on in the ring instead of worrying about what a couple of commentators are doing.
Gorilla, the only thing that makes any sense to me as to why Randy Savage would become so upset when all you were doing was asking Elizabeth a question, perhaps he's a little jealous.
Oh, he's obviously extremely jealous, but he could be a lot less jealous, more jealous, if he walks out of here without the gold. And it certainly appears that way right now. Look at that. He didn't do his homework. He's getting bent out of shape because that doesn't work on the dog. There he goes, over the top rope. That seems to be his only salvation, is to bail out of that ring. Look at the look on that face.
And here he comes again, Gorilla. Hey,
what is it with you? He's going to end up getting counted out of the ring here, worried about me. Can you believe that?
That very well happened.
Macho
Man! I guess I've got to ask, with some of the comments made tonight by the Macho Man directed towards you, Gorilla, any chance that...
Highly unlikely. Gorilla is retired. One count, two, no. Wow, he kicked out of there with authority. Elizabeth, obviously, she's very worried about what's happening here in the Summit, and rightly so, because it could be all over right here.
Could well
be. We could make history.
Gorilla, all I'd like to say is, if for whatever reason you decide to put end to that retirement, you and the Macho Man, that's one match I'd buy a front row ticket for, and I'd pay through the nose to see that.
You don't have to worry about spending any money there. It's not going to happen. Down for another headbutt and down for the cover foot over the bottom rope. Take a look, Dave.
Two counts for my
brother. You can see. The
dog said two counts doesn't make you a champ. I tell you, you got to give credit where credit is due. Savage knows exactly where he is at all times when he's inside that squared circle. Oh, look out here. Boy, he planted that one right underneath the chin of the dog. And the tables have turned just that quick. One count, two, and that's it. He is dangerous once he gets wound up. A nice block, a right hand. Look at the difference in the power of the shots here between these two individuals. It takes three or four from the Macho Man to add up to one of the dogs.
JYD says, if that's the way you want to go, it's fine with me, brother. You'll stand toe-to-toe with anyone.
ramming into the turnbuckle pad. Elizabeth really fat out of shape and concerned. And down again and out again onto the floor goes Savage.
I can't remember seeing Randy Savage in this serious a predicament during the course of a championship match, and J.Y.D. goes right out after him.
Oh, look at that. He pulled her right in front of him again. Give me a break.
He's coming over.
Pulled her right in front of him again. If I could have reached her, I'd have pulled her out of the way. Oh, ring the bell. Yes, definitely. Ring the bell. I don't know why, but we're ringing the bell. I guess both men have been counted out, I guess.
Now, wait a minute. Referee Dave Edner raised the Macho Man's hand, girl. I don't understand this.
You want me? You're a sick person. You're a sick person.
Get your shoes on.
Let's go up and get the official word.
Get your trunks on.
Gorilla,
I'll never forget you!
Gorilla, the challenge has definitely been made.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still Intercontinental Champion.
Look out!
Due to count out by the Junkyard Dog.
Oh, look out!
Randy Macho Man Savage.
Right off the top rope to the backside of the Junkyard Dog, and he came down. Look out, he's about to crack him again. No, there goes the belt. And the dog's on his feet, and the dog's got the belt.
Smart move by referee Dave Hebner.
He counted the Junkyard Dog outside the ring. Is that what the decision was, Kenny?
That's what it was, and for the life of me, Gorilla, I cannot believe it nor understand it.
I don't understand this at all. However, it remains fact here.
I cannot believe what I've just seen. Never in my entire wrestling career, I just do not believe it. Ricky Steamboat absolutely could not breathe. The medics behind this door here now, they actually had put a hole in it. They had put some kind of a tube for him to breathe. I've never seen things so gruesome in my life. Right now, they're working on him. The ambulance on its way. Soon as we know anything else, we'll bring it to you too.
Whoa! Going on here. What? He's got the bell.
Whoa.
He can't breathe. Look at that. He can't breathe.
Courtesy of Dr. Bob Panovich, who attended to the injuries of the Dragon Ricky Steamboat, we now will take you to his good offices and have a report on the extent of the injuries to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Let's take it now over to Dr. Bob Panovich.
With me at this time, Dr. Bob Panovich. He is the chief physician for the World Wrestling Federation. And doctor, I want to confront you with a complete assessment of the recent injury to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat at the hands of Macho Man Randy Savage.
Well, Gene, Ricky sustained a crushed larynx in this accident that occurred. There's no knowledge at this time about the extent of the injuries. He's able to breathe at this time. However, he does not have his voice and may require some speech therapy as time goes on. My concern at this time is whether his wrestling career is finished or not.
Well, wait a minute. You have any question at all that Ricky Steamboat's career is in jeopardy?
That's a good possibility at this time. We'll have to wait and see as time goes on whether or not he's recovered completely or not.
I understand at the time of the injury that Ricky Steamboat's wife, Bonnie, was absolutely hysterical, and I can understand that, and I imagine you can too, Doctor.
Absolutely, I can understand that also.
Okay, down the road, what do we look for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat in terms of the therapy that you alluded to?
Well, one thing I think he'll require is extensive speech therapy, something that will make him speak better as time goes on. And I think I'm worried about his ability to breathe and whether it's going to affect his cardiovascular response and training and things like that.
All right. A very unique, a very unusual, but perhaps a very devastating injury for the Dragon Ricky Steamboat. And for you, Dr. Bob Panovich, I appreciate your comments. That's the latest, bringing you up to date on the status, physical status of Ricky Steamboat. With me at this time, Dr. Bob Ponovich, the chief physician for the World Wrestling Federation, very vivid in the minds of millions of wrestling fans around the world, the recent injury to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat at the hands of Macho Man Randy Savage. Doctor, your assessment of Steamboat's injury.
Well, Ricky Steamboat received a crushed larynx and very severe damage to his vocal cords in this injury.
All right. In layman's terms, Doctor, just exactly what does that mean? Is it life-threatening?
Very much so. He was gasping for air and having trouble breathing. All of his vital signs were compromised at one time.
All right, I understand that his wife eyewitnessed that particular incident, and she became hysterical, which I can understand.
Absolutely. I was quite frightened myself.
Okay, the outlook for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. In your opinion, Doctor, is there a strong possibility he's going to be able to return to professional wrestling?
I worry about that possibility. I think that the injury...
What do you advise?
I think that he should quit professional wrestling.
All right. That is the latest status report from Dr. Bob Ponovich. Doctor, I thank you.
Thank you.
Led towards the ring by Elizabeth from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 239 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
Earlier on, the Macho Man had a few choice words. As we look at the lovely Elizabeth, here's what the Macho Man had to say.
One by one, and they'll carry him out the same way. Who's next? You'll all end up like the Dragon Steamboat. Gone forever, yeah!
I don't think SD will wind up that way. Everyone now will be gunning for the Macho Man, and I do not think that the Dragon Ricky Steamboat is gone forever, although obviously there's a lot of talk about the Dragon retiring. Yes?
Well, you know what, McMahon, it's always a sad case when you see an athlete that has to retire before his time, but you know, maybe it's all for the best in the case of the Dragon Ricky Steamboat. Maybe it was time. You know, fate deals a strange hand, and maybe his time is up, and he, I believe, personally should retire.
Steamboat suffering the crushed larynx. And later on, we're going to have an update on the condition of the Dragon Ricky Steamboat. Right now, look at this, the Macho Man hiding behind Elizabeth.
Well, that's the Macho Man. Not very macho, is he? I think he's disgusting.
Some macho there. Randy Savage.
You know, it's pretty tough to be an announcer out here with a biased person like Bruno sitting out here with me. How can I stay unbiased as an announcer with him?
All right, well, in the ring right now, SD, who's going to give the Macho Man more than a run for his money. You can see Savage on the outside. I wonder, Jesse, if you would care to comment on the recent actions of the Macho Man. I'm sure you would agree with all of us. What he did to Ricky Steamboat was certainly not called for, to say the least.
Well, I disagree with you, McMahon. You do what it takes to win. Apparently, Macho Man Savage felt that's what it took, and he did what he had to do, and you can't fault him for that. I fault Sammartino for his horrible reporting of the event.
Let me tell you something. I know what my job is as a reporter, but when I was there giving an update on the condition of Steamboat, which I was very upset because his career is threatened, and here's this I don't know what to call him, comes in, butts in, interferes, and he boasts about what he did to the man. You're darn right I went after his throat. I would do it all over. I know my job, but I will not take that kind of nonsense and abuse from anybody.
Savage quickly to the outside.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what, Macho Man not only possesses a great body, but he's a thinker in that ring, McMahon. You notice when the going gets a little rough,
he takes off.
That's right. He'll slide out and get it back together. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. In pro football, the quarterback runs out before he takes the hit, right? Right? And they call that brilliant moves.
You got a point.
You're darn right I do.
But certainly it's not the most sportsmanlike thing to do. You wonder what Elizabeth thinks of the Macho Man and his actions recently with the Dragon Ricky Steamboat. Macho Man for the ride, to the buckle. SD move.
Ooh, see what I said about being a thinker.
SD got caught there with the slingshot.
Hey, you're not going to be an Intercontinental Champion and not be a tremendous wrestler, which is what Randy Macho Man Savage is. And here he goes.
That was very close to the throat area there as well.
Totally legal. And no excuses out of you two because I notice that's Dave Hebner refereeing.
The Macho Man. Victorious.
Here is
the Intercontinental Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
The Macho Man and Elizabeth, victorious. I wonder if the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat, is looking on.
I doubt it. I don't think he's looking on. I think Steamboat should just take retirement gracefully.
Here we go to the replay, Bruno.
Well, over here we see SD Jones makes a mistake here. He's a little too slow in coming in and gets caught with a clothesliner. You don't make a mistake with a guy like Savage. Unfortunately, he did. Then he went over the top rope and as usual uses his elbow coming off the top rope. And of course, that was more than enough to finish SD Jones, at least with this particular bout.
More than enough to finish off anyone. The Macho Man continues his reign of victories and indeed his reign of terror. We take you now.
The most devastating injuries I can ever recall here in the World Wrestling Federation occurred recently in a match between Randy, the Macho Man Savage, and Ricky, the Dragon Steamboat. During the course of that match, brutal tactics utilized by Savage, and as a result, Ricky Steamboat sustained a very serious injury to his throat. With me at this time, Mrs. Steamboat. Mrs. Steamboat, distraught, despondent, we can understand.
Well, Gene, I'm not only distraught and despondent, I'm angry. I mean, Rick really had to suffer over this injury.
You know, there are many of those here in the World Wrestling Federation that contend that the injury suffered by your husband at the hands of Macho Man Randy Savage, many say it was totally intentional.
Well, Gene, of course it was intentional. He jumped from the top rope. He crushed Rick's throat. I mean, he didn't have any reason to attack Rick that way. I just don't have anything but hatred for that man.
Time, World Wrestling Federation official referee, Daddy Davis. Recently, Mr. Davis, you were involved in a very controversial match involving Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and the Intercontinental Champion, Macho Man Randy Savage. Now, I happen to know for a fact that the official referee assigned to that match was none other than Dave Hebner. Yet, for some reason, you interjected yourself. Exactly why, Mr. Davis, were you there?
That's none of your business.
Mr. Davis, I don't feel that's quite adequate. As that sensational match between these two tremendous athletes progressed, once again, you chose to interject yourself as these two men went at it tooth and nail.
I thought it was the right thing to do.
You thought it was the right thing to do?
Exactly.
This man who is revered by millions throughout the world, suffering a very serious injury to his larynx. This man may never wrestle again. Is there any guilt? Are there any reservations within you yourself that you may be in part responsible for the end to Mr. Steamboat's career?
Not at all. The way I figure it, that's the breaks.
Well, in my opinion, and I think the American public deserves some answers, you're giving me nothing. I think you've lost all sense of objectivity. And this isn't the first time that this man has been embroiled in controversy. Who are you?
Complete mental insanity. Oh, yeah. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, your future seems bleak. Oh, yeah, it does. But you got involved over your head, didn't you? Macho Man Randy Savage, number one wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation. Take your wife's advice. Retire. Understand that you're learning sign language now. Understand you're trying to talk. Communicate. Two more signs that maybe you can add to your repertoire. Number one could be possibly this Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Yeah, your future. And then possibly that if you ever decide to come back and wrestle the Macho Man Randy Savage.
The Intercontinental title on the line at the Boston Garden January 3rd. The Macho Man Randy Savage, accompanied by Elizabeth, will be facing the challenge Macho Man of wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And a lot of people feel that this time you went too far.
Well, is that right, Mr. TV announcer? What do you figure? Do you figure it can happen or do you figure it can't happen? You think that the Macho Man Randy Savage can teach an old dog new tricks? Can you do it? Yeah, can you do it? Yes, I can. Yes, I can! And I can do it in the Boston Gardens on January the 3rd. Oh, yeah, that's a great fitting, setting. Because right there in the Boston Gardens a long, long time ago, February the 8th, Macho Man won the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt. And a longer time ago, and I'm talking years and years and years and years ago, Bruno Sammartino got himself the living legend, yeah, attitude going for him where you're an old dog and I'm going to teach you a new trick. You're a has-been. You're a has-been, Mr. Cheap Shot. Don't like you, don't like anything about you, and all in one day in the Boston Garden. I'm going to eat you up. I'm going to teach you respect for the youngers, yeah. Macho Madness.
With me, once again, Dr. Bob Panovich, who is the chief physician for the World Wrestling Federation. I am looking, doctor, for a status, a physical status report on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. What is the latest?
Gene, I'm amazed at the man's recuperative abilities. He's had an amazing recovery at this point from his initial injuries.
I think a lot of that is due to the tremendous heart of Ricky Steamboat and certainly the phenomenal physical condition that he is in.
I'm absolutely sure of that fact. I think he's in such good condition that he had this remarkable recovery because of that fact.
Now, Ricky Steamboat has vowed to return to the ring, and I'm very curious, Doctor, what would the possible consequences be if he should ever be struck in that area of the throat of the larynx?
I worry about that, Gene. I think that that area has been weakened, and I think another blow to that area could be very disastrous to his career, and perhaps even fatal.
That does not sound good. I thank you, however, for that information, Dr. Bob Panovich.
The battle for the Intercontinental title. In fact, I was at Boston Garden when the matchup was announced. The Macho Man Randy Savage against wrestling's living legend Bruno Sammartino. And certainly Bruno Sammartino, the roof almost came right off the Boston Garden. But Bruno, it's understandable why he decided to come out of retirement to put the tights back on. For those of you that missed it, after what the Macho Man Randy Savage did to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, Bruno back in the dressing room area trying to update the condition of the Dragon. The Macho Man comes up with a tirade of insults which continued even after the camera stopped rolling. And then Bruno, even today, earlier, the Macho Man out here continually referring to you, if you will, as a cheap shot artist.
You know, Kenny, when I was a very young man and I first became a professional wrestler, I was so elated to meet some of the great stars of professional wrestling, former champions, just people who had made their mark in professional wrestling. I looked at them with great respect and admiration because that's where I was brought up, and so many of my peers are the same way. Here's this guy, an intercontinental champion, that when you have a title, you're supposed to bring it with some class because you're looked up to by certain people. You are a champion. That means that you're better, a better competitor perhaps than others, and that's how you got there. This guy called me everything. All I kept hearing that night was nothing but a washed up old man. He referred something to my ethnic, you know, as far as my nationality. I was so furious that he tried to say that he lured me to get back into the ring to come because he wanted to destroy the legend once and for all. Well, I'm going to tell you something, Macho Man. I am coming. I'm putting on the tights back on again. First of all, because of not only what you did, the cheap shot with Steamboat to use that steel weapon on the man's throat, using that steel railing around there. You almost crippled the man, and we don't even know if he's going to have a future in wrestling again. We don't know if he's going to be able to come back. And then you tried to treat me like this. Well, I'm going to tell you something. I'm not after your title because titles mean nothing to me. I've had my titles, 12 years world champion. But I'm going to come into that ring, and I'm going to show you that this washed up old man has enough left in him to make mincemeat out of you. I'm going to come in that ring for one reason. I'm going to mop up that floor with you. And if you try to escape like I see you so often do to save your title, I'll come after you outside the ring. A tutti voi italiani, vi voglio dire una cosa. Questo disgraziato che si dice che lui è campione mondiale e come parla come un porco, quando io lo incontro a Boston, questo qua lo faccio sentire tanto miserabile quella sera, perché quando io ho finito con lui, lui si vergogna a farsi vedere più sul ring, perché mai sono stato arrabbiato così come adesso, ma questo disgraziato deve pagare per questi peccati che ha fatto, e a Boston lui deve pagare.
Boston, Saturday, January 3rd, the Macho Man and the Living Legend.
The following is a one-fall non-title bout. Making his way to the ring, accompanied by his manager, Elizabeth, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 236 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
aggressively.
He does make an entrance, don't he?
He certainly does.
Top title matchup. Certainly doesn't spare any expense in his ring attire or that of Elizabeth.
You can bet on that. Money's no object there.
You wouldn't know anything about that.
You wouldn't either.
The opponent from Milford, Connecticut, weighing 241 pounds, Mario Mancini.
Mario Mancini supplying the opposition in this non-title matchup with the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Macho or Not-So-Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Don't just report it like it is. Call it like it is. So Macho Man Randy Savage.
No, he's not so macho in my book. Especially after the disgusting display that he did on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, trying to terminate that youngster's career.
Oh, my heart goes out for the Dragon. You know what his wife's so upset about? Because she's going to do all the housework now. She doesn't have Steamboat to help her like he usually does with the dishes and the garbage.
Macho Man really not all that concerned about what kind of damage he did, in fact, to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, who incidentally has been getting some speech therapy and a whole lot of extracurricular work being done on him because his speech patterns are... Oh, look at that. That's the same type move right there that put the Dragon out of commission. As the Macho Man now going to the top turnbuckle. Bombs away, double axe handle right to the back of the head. We had a chance to speak with the Macho Man on the injury to the Dragon. Let's go to the tape.
Poor little baby Dragon can't talk. Our sign language is for little kids. How's this one for your career? And if you ever want to go against the Macho Man again, how's this one?
Up from that.
Nobody. You think the Dragon's home watching?
I'm
he's
sure.
Convalescing?
I'm sure.
You know what he's saying right now?
What?
Nothing.
Well, he's working on it.
The winner of this bout, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Randy Macho Man Savage.
Very impressive this week here on Wrestling Challenge. The reigning champion, as we take a good look at the beautiful Elizabeth. Savage is showing no mercy to anyone here in the wrestling wars of the World Wrestling Federation. Look at this patented move right here.
Nobody gets up from that. And you know what I was wondering about Monsoon? Look at this. I like this part here, the intimidation here. Ah. 1 foot on. Two. It's all over. I was wondering, since Steamboat is taking speech therapy now, Savage ought to break his hand so he can't talk.
Now is to increase the strength of your vocal cords. I'd like you to say this vowel after me. E. E. Okay, now you're trying, but I want it to be more crisp. E. 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 E.
E. E. E. E. Macho Man Randy Savage, accompanied by Elizabeth, and the challenger, none other than wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And if any building Randy Savage belongs to Bruno Sammartino, it's got to be the Boston Garden.
Bruno Sammartino is a fool. He's a stupid fool. He is the one person in this world that actually can stand on top of a mountain and shout to all the world that he is a complete idiot, that everyone out there going out of his mind. Yeah, I've got to agree with you. I know that Bruno Sammartino's history is, stems and roots in the Boston Garden. So is the Macho Man Randy Savage. But I, Bruno Sammartino, am doing the thing now. And you did the thing 200 years ago. In fact, even then, if the Macho Man Randy Savage would have been around, you would have been number two for him. You understand that, Mr. Cheap Shot? In the Boston Gardens, it's going to be your last night in professional wrestling. Yeah, teach an old dog new tricks. I can do that. Yeah, I can teach you a new trick.
I can teach you how to peg right there in the Boston Garden. Macho Madness. Oh, yeah, when all the people all around the world have sent cards and letters to see the dragon's funeral. Help them get well. I know the dragon appreciates it. And the Macho Man, Randy Savage, appreciates it too. But just one thing. Yeah, don't expect Ricky the Dragon Steamboat to read them out loud, because he can't do that, no.
The Intercontinental title on the line, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, facing the challenge of wrestling's own living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And Bruno, it's certainly understandable as to why you decided to come out of retirement and wanted Randy Savage, but I know you don't want to see it, but there's been so much talk amongst the people who missed it last time. Bruno, I'd like to, if you will, bear with me. We'd like to show the incident that took place in the dressing room area following what Randy Savage did to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Well, I can never forget. I can't get it out of my mind what happened on that incident. But yes, let the fans see it. Let them see what happened, and they'll know why perhaps I feel the way I feel.
If you have any wonder as to why Bruno Sammartino is coming out of retirement here in Boston January 3rd to challenge the Macho Man Randy Savage, I'd like to take you back a few weeks ago.
There's nothing really new to report. Ricky Steamboat has been taken to the hospital by ambulance. He was in agony. His breathing is terrible, even though he has a tube down his throat. All of his friends are back here. We're waiting for further news, further reports. It was one of the most devastating things I've ever seen. No excuse in the world for it. There was no reason by this slime, the so-called jacket.
Well, yeah, what's the update? Tell me, man. Well, it's in the house.
Are you happy about it?
It's in the hot dog to the hospital yet, huh? Put some mustard on him right now. Get him all set up for the champion right here. I'm so proud of myself.
You
taste that slime. You're happy about
it's really understandable.
Man, let me tell you something, okay? After what he did, I have no regrets whatsoever about attacking him as I did. And the only regret I do have is that those people interfered. I know that they had good intent, but I wish they had not interfered because I could have ended with this jackass once and for all. But I'm going to tell you something. You've been insulting me like crazy. I've worked up old man and so forth. When I get you in that ring, you're going to so regret that you ever heard the name of Bruno Sammartino. Because Bruno Sammartino is going to be the man who's going to humiliate you, embarrass you, and as far as your title, you know what you can do with that title, pal. I don't want your title, so you don't have to pull any cheap stuff like you've done with other opponents by getting yourself probably disqualified or get counted out. With me, I'm not after your title. In fact, when I take that title off you, I'm going to put it up for grabs. I'm going to put it up for elimination tournament. All I'm after is that I'm going to make a real jerk out of you and expose you to the punk that you really are.
Have been conferring about the condition of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. With me, Dr. Potovich and Dr. Jarrett, I'd like to get your opinion, your assessment of Ricky Steamboat's injury.
With an injury to the larynx, it can be a life-threatening injury. The problem you deal with a competitive athlete like he is the desire that he has to return to the ring and the likelihood of another injury being a fatal injury.
All right, do we have a difference of opinion now between the two of you and other doctors that have investigated and looked into this case?
Well, I know Ricky Steamboat personally, and I know what a tremendous competitor he is and the great condition that he's always in, and I think that's going to be a real factor, a real positive plus for him.
Is there a strong possibility Ricky Steamboat has vowed to return to the World Wrestling Federation, in your opinion, that he can return?
I would advise that he did not. I think the uncertainty about it is just too great to allow him to return.
All right. A lot of conversation regarding Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Doctors, I thank you very much.
Girl next door, whatever.
I don't think so, Jeff.
You know, I'd like to make a statement here, McMahon, real quick, if I might. You know, there's been all this brought out about Ricky Steamboat and the possibility of his retirement at the hands of the Macho Man. Well, I don't understand what it's all about. I mean, plenty of athletes have their careers ended short. It's tragic, but it happens in the world of sports. I mean, look what happened to Gale Sayers in football, right?
Well, it's not going to happen to the Dragon, I don't think at all.
I think so. I think the man should just take his retirement, think of his career as being successful, and go on to something else.
All right, Mick Kaninsky, this young man, a very promising young athlete in the World Wrestling Federation, to meet the Macho Man. Get outstanding matchup.
Well, Macho Man's going to get tested because Nick Kaninsky's big, he's strong, he's young and aggressive.
Arm drag takedown. Referee, by the way, happens to be Danny Davis.
So what's the matter with that?
How about that nice shootout there by Kaninsky?
Beautiful shootout. Hey, Macho Man doesn't duck anyone. You notice that Macho Man, he always wrestles good, tough opponents.
Yeah. We asked Danny Davis earlier on if he minded being booed by the fans as he is so often. This is what he had to say.
The fans booing, bothering me? Are you kidding? Fans don't bother me. The only thing I'm concerned with when I referee is what's going on in the ring. You fans can boo, holler, scream, do anything you like.
Now that, McMahon, to me is a tremendous answer from a tremendous referee. He does not concern himself with the fans. He concerns himself only with what's happening in the ring, as a referee should.
Yes, he concerns himself with it, all right. Look at that maneuver. Kaninsky, one. Well, a slow count there, no?
Was not a slow count. He's consistent. As long as there's consistency in the count, McMahon, that's all that matters. Whether it be some referees are a little faster, others are a little slower, as long as they are consistent.
The Macho Man breaking the rhythm, breaking the momentum young Nick Kaninsky.
That's one thing as a wily veteran that you always do in the ring is try to get a feel for each particular referee's count.
So, whoa, Macho! Wow, Kaninsky moments ago hit the Macho Man about 10 feet straight up. Kaninsky wants a faster count.
Kaninsky should worry about pinning the Macho Man, not a faster count.
Kaninsky, drop kick! A cover!
Down to one is all he can get. Referee out of position.
Hey, come on, ref! Reversal, Kaninsky kick. No, what's this? Oh, fine body just missed.
Oh, yeah.
Macho Man scooping up. No, it's ball package! I think maybe he should have had the count of three on it. It was tough to see where we were. Oh, no, look at that. Knee right to the shoulder area.
McMahon, I get tired of you and Bruno always making excuses when your favorites aren't winning.
How good across the neck of Nick Kaninsky.
Now, you know, this young man started off quick. He's got a lot of potential. But he's finding out now what it's like to step into the ring with the Intercontinental Champion.
Macho Man climbing Nick Kaninsky. What's he going to do now? Up to the apron. Climbing up to the top rope. Macho Man leaps.
Whoa. I believe it's over. One, two, three. Now there was a consistent count. He counted the same way for Kaninsky as he did there for the Macho Man. I don't want to hear no more about that.
The Macho Man.
Good fight, but once he got caught and the Macho Man comes off the top rope with his elbow in, that was the end of Kaninsky. And fun, look at that. He really came down with all that weight down on top of Kaninsky's chest and his defense.
Aren't you two going to say that move should be banned now?
Oh, come on, Jesse, give me a break. Let's take you to the update.
Savage, I want you listening up now. I'm talking to you. You are a priority in my career right now. Before the end comes, you will have suffered.
Intercontinental title is on the line. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, will be facing the challenge of wrestling's living legend, Bruno San Martino. And a lot of people feel, Macho Man, promoters and championship committee alike, after all your actions, finally, you have gone one step too far.
Stupid enough to listen to what Bruno San Martino says. And are you ignorant enough to make an impression on your stupid brain? Well, Saturday night in Boston, if you're like this stupid idiot, then you're probably, going to be in for the shock of your lifetime. You call me a punk, Bruno San Martino. Well, you couldn't tie this punk's shoes at any time during your career. And for that statement alone, not only would you pay with the 1-2-3 count and that elbow going across your throat, no, Saturday night, you're going to get embarrassed. Yeah, really embarrassed. Real bad, yeah. Along with the loss will be the embarrassment of the living legend. Yeah, but you got danger number 3 looking at you, Bruno San Martino, Mr. Sweet Shot. Yeah, you do. The looming danger of the strong possibility of getting your career, your wrestling career, and your life to an end. Mickey the Dragon Steamboat, save a bed for the living legend, Mr. Cheap Shot, Saturday Night at Boston.
Macho Man, I gotta ask you this question. Now, I've done damage to people in the ring. Members of my family have done damage to wrestlers in the ring. But I've never seen anybody do damage the way you did to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and his throat and his neck. Now, here's the question I gotta ask you. Do you feel any remorse? Do you feel sorry for the Dragon Steamboat?
I felt sorry for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat when he first wrestled the Macho Man Randy Savage early in the match. And then I felt even more sorry for him when I came down off that top rope and his neck was laying on the banister. Yeah, just set so pretty, yeah. And then I felt sorry for him when I stood on top of the top turnbuckle and I came down sky high right on his throat. But I really feel sorry for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat if he ever steps into the ring with the Macho Man Randy Savage ever again.